If you've seen any other videos on this channel, you're probably familiar that all engines generally come in families. Manufacturer will develop one engine and then change it as needed with different variants to suit new applications or new emission standards or whatever they need. Now this is pretty much the case with almost all Toyota engines. The Toyota UZ is one of the more popular engine families that Toyota built, and it's pretty much their most popular V8 engine family that they've built. So grab your popcorn or sit down, because today we're going to cover everything in the Toyota UZ engine family, including the 1UZ, the 2UZ, and the 3UZ. Let's go. Let's start with the 1UZ FE, which is the first engine in the Toyota UZ engine family. Toyota designed this engine to replace the outdated Toyota 5V engine. Starting with some of the basics, the cylinder block of the 1UZ is made of cast aluminum and uses a 90 degree design. The cylinder heads are also made of aluminum, making the total package fairly lightweight for such a physically large engine. Because you have to remember that putting dual overhead cams on a 90 degree V8 doesn't exactly make for a tightly packaged system. Later versions of the 1UZ FE received Toyota's Vvti system, which improved horsepower and fuel economy. A nice feature about the 1UZ is that if the timing belt breaks, the valves do not interfere with the pistons because it is a non-interference motor, at least the non-VVT motors are. To save some time, because we have more engines to cover, I'll throw some of the basic specs of this engine on the screen for you to see here to give you a basic idea of what this engine is all about. Now, if we were to look at some of the applications, Toyota used this mostly in luxury and sports cars. They use this in the Lexus GS400, LS400, and SC400. They also use this engine in the Toyota Ariso, Celsior, Soar, and Crown. Like I mentioned, the 1UZ has come in a few different forms over the years. Toyota did make some changes, and of all those changes, the most important one was the addition of their VVTi system. The engine started at 256 horsepower and 260 pound-feet, and then Toyota added higher compression pistons, which bumped the power up to 261 horsepower and 269 pound-feet. The addition of VVTi bumped it up to 290 horsepower and 300 pound-feet, and the final version of the 1UZ had some minor revisions and tuning, which bumped the power all the way up to 300 horsepower and 310 pound-feet. As you might be able to tell from these numbers, the VVTi was the most important change that Toyota added to the 1UZ, and it increased power by 34 horsepower and 40 foot-pounds of torque, and more importantly, it brought peak torque down by 400 RPM, which makes it a very, very good street motor with a lot of power all throughout the power range. Now, if we were to look at what you can do with a 1UZ with the help of some aftermarket parts, it can actually make a lot of power naturally aspirated, but it is pretty expensive to build an NA 1UZ. The cheaper option to make a lot of power out of a 1UZ is to stick on a Terminator, Cobra Supercharger, or an Eaton M90. Much like other Toyota engines, the 1UZ has a very, very strong block, and it's really not something you're gonna have to worry about unless you're making well north of 1,000 horsepower. Nissan's VH40 5DE is really the only competitor that the 1UZ had when it was new. They both come from Japan, they're both dual overhead cam V8s, and they both have a displacement of less than 4.6 liter. The VH45 did make an impressive amount of power, around 278 horsepower and 294 pound-feet of torque, but that is less than the 1UZ made in its final form. That's pretty impressive considering that the 1UZ is also smaller than the VH45, but this is all a topic for a different time. Moving on, let's look at the 2UZ, which is the second engine in the Toyota UZ engine family. The 2UZ is pretty much directly based off of the 1UZ, but in this case, it was actually designed for a much different application set than the 1UZ, where the 1UZ was used mostly in luxury cars and sort of sporty cars with the SC400. The 2UZ is designed specifically for use in trucks and SUVs. With the application set being vastly different, the 2UZ did have to go underneath some major changes in order for it to be best suited for trucks and SUVs. And the most obvious change going from the 1UZ to the 2UZ is the increase in displacement from 4 liters up to 4.7 liters. They also ditched the cast aluminum block in favor of cast iron block. Now, the 2UZ doesn't have the cult following that the 1UZ or the 3UZ does, and that's pretty much because of the block, which is quite a bit heavier because it's cast iron instead of cast aluminum, but also the 2UZ has a weaker bottom end, which we'll talk about in just a little bit. Other than the change in displacement and the cylinder block material, the engine design is actually very, very similar to the 1UZ. It's a 90 degree V8 with aluminum heads, dual overhead cam, 4 valves per cylinder, and it was in production from 1998 all the way up until 2012, although in most places it died in around 2009. Toyota began replacing it with the 1UR FE and the 3UR FE in 2010. To increase displacement from 4 liters to 4.7 liters, Toyota increased the bore from 87.5 millimeters to 94 millimeters and the stroke from 82.5 millimeters to 84 millimeters. Aside from bore and stroke, the 2UZ block is very similar to the 1UZ it's based on in design and dimensions. It also has a 90 degree V angle, 21 millimeter bank offset and a bore pitch of 105.5 millimeters. An interesting change made in the bottom end is a reduction from 6 main bearing journals down to 5. Now, like the 1UZ, the 2UZ went under quite a few changes throughout its lifetime, but the most important change that Toyota made was the addition of their VVTi system. With VVTi, valve overlap can be adjusted at any given RPM, and this is the case with the 1UZ, 2UZ, and the 3UZ, and pretty much any engine with VVTi for that matter, and it really helps it be as efficient as possible at any given RPM. As far as fuel and spark goes, the 2UZ uses sequential multi-port fuel injection system with 8 four-hole fuel injectors and a mass airflow sensor. It's also equipped with Toyota's direct ignition system, which uses individual coils for all 8 cylinders instead of a distributor. Another interesting thing you'll find on top of every 2UZ is Toyota's variable length intake manifold. With this system, the 2UZ can change how long the intake runners are at a specific RPM, which has a big impact on air velocity and basically how much power the engine makes. Typically, what you'll see is with a longer intake runner, you'll make more low-end torque, and with a shorter intake runner, you'll make more high-end power. And with this system, there's a valve in the intake manifold which can either route air straight down into the cylinder or can force it around into a loop to effectively increase the length of the intake runner and then down into the engine. Inside the VVT version of this engine, you'll also find a lighter rotating assembly and oil jets to help keep the pistons cool. Toyota also increased the compression ratio up to 10 to 1 to further improve efficiency and power output. The 2UZ came in a variety of different Toyota products, but like I mentioned, it was mostly designed for trucks and SUVs. The 2UZ was equipped in the Lexus GX470 and LX470. It was also equipped in the Toyota 4Runner, Land Cruiser, Sequoia, and the Tundra. Like the 1UZ, the 2UZ had minor changes done to it over the years to increase horsepower, torque, and fuel efficiency. The biggest change would be the addition of Toyota's VVTi system, and to save some time, I'll just throw some power specs on the screen for you to see here. And as you can tell from these numbers, the 2UZ ended up with 52 more horsepower and 22 pound-feet of torque more than when it first was produced. The largest jump occurred when Toyota added VVTi, which added a very, very impressive amount of power. Like the 1UZ, a popular modification for somebody who really wants to make a lot of power out of this engine is going to be a Terminator Cobra Supercharger or Eaton M90. Now, with this bolted onto a 2UZ, you can very easily make 360 horsepower or more, and with a built bottom end, fuel injectors, and obviously all the supporting mods, you can easily make north of 450 horsepower. It is worth noting that Toyota did at one point make a TRD supercharger for this engine, but it is no longer available. You can still find them on eBay used, but I would kind of recommend staying away from that because buying parts for a discontinued supercharger is going to be a little bit difficult. There are two issues with shoving a ton of boost into a 2UZ. That's going to be 2-bolt main caps and weak connecting rods. This is an important distinction that makes the 2UZs quite a bit less popular than the 1UZ or the 3UZ, because those have 4-bolt main caps, and the 2-bolt main caps are not nearly as strong, and it really has a much more difficult time holding the crank into place, especially when you introduce forced induction into the equation. And with this stock connecting rods, they are very, very weak. In fact, you can see some instances of the stock connecting rods breaking in entirely stock form with zero modifications at all. So if you're gonna throw a boost at this engine, I would highly recommend adding a built bottom end to it. A common and interesting build is using a 2UZ bottom end and block with all 1UZ components on the top end. This allows you to turn something like an LS400 into an LS470. It's not a super common build for the simple fact that you can build your engine with a supercharger or turbo for the same amount of money and probably make more power, but it's still really cool nonetheless. So overall, the 2UZ is a lot like the 1UZ FE. They are used for different applications, but their parts are mostly interchangeable. The 2UZ is super torquey and super strong, and it's relatively small compared to its competitor engines, but it makes as much torque or more at a lower RPM than comparable truck engines of the time. Now, last but not least, let's look at the 3UZ, which is also based on the 1UZ, and the biggest difference between the 1UZ and the 3UZ is the increased displacement from 4 liters up to 4.3 liters. Unlike the 2UZ, the 3UZ was actually designed for sports cars and luxury cars like the original 1UZ. It also shares the same all-aluminum design as the 1UZ, so gone is the cast iron block that you'd find on a 2UZ. To increase displacement from 4 liters to 4.3 liters, Toyota increased bore from 87.5 millimeters to 91 millimeters. While leaving stroke the same at 82.5 millimeters. This makes the 3UZ quite over square, and it allows it to reach a very high peak RPM without stressing the internals excessively. If you want a better explanation of how bore and stroke work and how it affects piston speed, peak RPM, engine stability, and more, check out the video. I'll leave it linked up in one of these corners, and it explains it in a much better detail. The block has the same 90 degree V, 21 millimeter cylinder bank offset, and 105.5 millimeter bore pitch as the ONE-U ZFE. Interestingly enough, Toyota decreased the thickness of the cast iron cylinder liners by half a millimeter. Now, this helps reduce weight on the ONE-U Z and also helps improve cooling, but it does come at the cost of strength, which we'll talk about in just a moment. Like the ONE-U Z, the 3-U Z uses a forged steel crankshaft, forged steel connecting rods, and cast lightweight aluminum pistons. And this is a good example of Toyota just simply overbuilding their engines like they pretty much always do. In stock form, the 3-U Z is really stronger than it needs to be for the amount of power that it makes. The 3-U Z cylinder heads are nearly identical to the cylinder heads found on the 1-U Z, and in fact, 1-U Z heads will actually bolt straight onto a 3-U Z block and will work completely fine with some minor modifications to the pistons for valve clearance. Like the 2-U Z, another thing that you'll find on the 3-U Z is Toyota's variable length intake manifold system. Now, this works pretty much exactly the same as it does on the 2-U Z, and again, it has a big impact on where the engine makes power most efficiently. Now, to recap on some of the info on the 3-U Z, we're looking at a production run from 2000 to 2010 in production cars, although it was used past that in Toyota race cars, an all-aluminum design, dual overhead cams, VVTi, Toyota's variable length intake manifold system, 4 valves per cylinder, and a 10.5 to 1 compression ratio. With that out of the way, let's look at some of the applications that the 3-U Z was used in. Like the 1-U Z, the 3-U Z was designed to be used in luxury cars and luxury sporty type of cars. You'll find this engine in the GS430, the LS430, and the SC430, which is a pretty hideous car that I don't even want to think about. And you'll also find it in the Toyota Crown Majesty. Over the years, Toyota gave the 3-U Z some minor upgrades. These upgrades increased horsepower, torque, and fuel efficiency. So with these upgrades, there are three power ratings for the 3-U Z depending on the year and application that you'll find it in. Power increases are relatively minor, and to save some time, I'll just throw those power figures on the screen for you to see here. And as you can tell from these power figures, there were only slight gains in horsepower. Most of these gains were a result of a computer calibration, and the physical parts were mostly left unchanged. Now, 3-U Z is a double-edged sword because although it's a lot like the 1-U Z, it's not exactly like the 1-U Z, and the big downside is the increased bore size, which led to decreased cylinder liner thickness. Now, assuming you're not making a crazy amount of power, the stock cylinder liners on the 3-U Z are fine. But say if you're pushing above 500 or 600 horsepower, the stock cylinder liners on the 3-U Z are going to fail much, much sooner than they would on the 1-U Z, where they're a bit thicker. So to recap all this info, the 1-U Z came first. It was designed to be used in luxury and sports cars. The 2-U Z came second. It was designed to be used in trucks and SUVs. And the 3-U Z came last, and it was also designed to be used in luxury and sports cars like the original 1-U Z. They all share the same basic architect: dual overhead cams, 4 valves per cylinder, VVTi, and so on. The only real major difference between all three of these is going to be the displacement and the fact that the 2-U Z uses a cast iron block rather than a cast aluminum block. So that's the entire Toyota U Z engine family in a nutshell. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please smash the thumbs up button because it really helps me out and helps the channel grow quite a bit. Get subscribed so you don't miss out on future videos. Check out all the other videos we have on the channel. We've covered other Toyota engines, the rest of the U Z engine family, tons of GM, LS engines, and a whole lot more. And I'll see you guys in the next one.